Chief Engineer's Log, Stardate 57835.62. It's been a couple of weeks since we left the Carstairs Anomaly, and we were sent to the planet Centria to deal with some scientist. At least I think he's a scientist. He's been violating General Order 1. During the journey, I kept finding weird technical glitches that appear at random and seem to affect entire systems. I think I've finally got the subtle hint of banana pudding out of the food replicator patterns, but now there's some weird glitch in the scanners in Medical Bay. But I'll get to that in a minute. First, I've got to talk about the transaxionic confinement capacitor, or as I like to call it, the ripcord. So I have been tinkering with this thing for a couple of years now. I've never liked the idea of being on a planet and having to wait for a standard transporter sequence to complete, especially if it's an emergency. I had an idea that if I could pre-charge the energy needed for a transport and have it linked to the ship, we could make the dematerialization sequence almost instantaneous. And it worked! I had tried it a couple of times myself back on my last posting, but after how things went down, I've been nervous about presenting it to the Starfleet Engineering Board, let alone Captain Novak. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get any additional testing in before the away team found themselves in a situation where the ripcords were going to be helpful. I haven't fully gotten them so you don't feel weak and like you need to empty your stomach after you use it. They're also only good for one use, but dang if Lieutenant Trawl didn't use it with style. I think they used to call it parkour, where a person would run around an old city jumping and climbing over walls and roofs before they invented countergrav. And that's basically what the lieutenant did in order to capture one of the bodyguards of the scientist. I hadn't tested the ripcord with two people, but it seemed to work just fine. So, needless to say, I'm going to have to do some more testing, but, you know, got him back to the ship. He ended up in sickbay, but that's... yeah, we'll deal with that later. But that's also where I discovered the latest quirk in our systems. Somehow the auxiliary magnetic differential is out of alignment. And while it's not really a problem in most cases, for some reason it says that Lieutenant Trawl is a joined Trill, even though he's already told us that he doesn't have a symbiote. I'm not sure we would have found this quirk if it hadn't been for the ripcord, but I'm also curious as to why most of the issues keep showing up in sickbay. Anyhow, the ship is humming along great for the most part, and honestly, I've got a great engineering crew. I know we'll get these quirks ironed out, but I'm definitely curious as to what's going to happen next. Alright, here's a personal addendum. Holy crap, I love the ripcord. Well, I mean, outside of the nausea and weakness. I think I can get it working right, but the fact that they're one use and I'm still having to make them without a replicator is really frustrating. I would love to be able to just replicate them as needed, but until I can solve those side effects, I think it's safest to just make them one at a time. I'm okay with keeping enough on hand for testing and an away team, but I think it's best to just keep closer track to how they're working and how the usage affects them during burnout. Other than that, honestly, I'm just trying to stay off the captain's bad side. I don't know what it is, but he does not like me, and I'm worried that he thinks I'm risking the crew with the ripcords. I don't know how to tell them that they're safe, well, mostly safe, without risking him kicking me off the ship. Oh well, I've got to get back to sickbay and get that differential squared away. Oh, and find time for a haircut. I'm surprised the captain hasn't even put me on report for this mess of hair on my head. Maybe my Niners hat is keeping him from noticing. Anyhow. Alright, folks, that is the Captain's Log for Star Trek Sojourner. If you come back every other Tuesday, you will find it here on Gaming with the ADHD, or you can watch it live on Bear the Gen X GM's channel, where if you super chat, you can actually affect the game by giving us threat or momentum. So keep that in mind, but regardless, if you enjoyed the video, please do give it a thumbs up. And, you know, put it down in the comment. What'd you think? Have you been watching Sojourner? Are you following along with the adventures of our crew? Regardless, love to hear from you, and we'll talk to you next time.